What's good, y'all? It's Jay Carfee on the vid. How's everyone doing out there in the YouTube world? But listen, we know a lot's been going on in the hip-hop world. A lot of BS and fuckery since 6ix9ine's been on this campaign ever since, you know, Gooba dropped. And we knew it was coming. We knew it was just a matter of time. You know what I mean? Now, I cover some of this stuff from time to time, whether you like 6ix9ine or not. You know what I mean? We know this guy's in the news, right? And I've been predicted it. This man would have that career in the entertainment industry, maybe even in the music industry, right? But what all this, what he's doing right now, what he's so hard at work doing, which I pointed out in a recent video I've done, trying to run this reverse psychology and all this other stuff that he's doing. He's putting in work. He's hard at work, right? Because even though this dude's successful, you know what I mean, with this hit Gooba and everything, and you know, it seems for the most part a lot of people are rocking with him, he's not happy fully, because deep down inside, this man's hurting because he wants to be accepted within the hip hop community. You know what I mean? Just because of like some fans are messing with him, which we knew a lot of his fans were gonna mess with him. You know what I mean? A lot of them don't care about that street code. You know what I mean? And something that I point out every time I drop these videos is not everyone who's a hip hop fan lives by the street code. You know what I mean? But the street code, there is elements of the street code in the hip hop culture. But you know what I mean? There's nothing wrong with being a civilian, a taxpayer, none of that. You know what I mean? But with 6ix9ine, it's a little different because he called himself being a gangster, running with some gangsters, doing some gangster things. And then when he went down, he put them guys away. You know what I mean? That's a fact, right? But why he's doing all this, dissing Snoop, calling people out, trying to see who will rock with him, who won't, is because even though, you know, he's sitting on some M's, got some millions of dollars, got some jewelry, got a hit song, he's mad, he's hurt, he wants to be back accepted into the hip hop community. Period. That's what it is. You know what I mean? That's what all this is about. That's what him, especially this Snoop thing. You know, Snoop chimed in on the Meek Mill 6ix9ine situation, which once again, you know, for those who watch the video, I'm sorry, I always got to mention it within these videos, but you got to go watch my Rock Nation 6ix9ine video, Jay-Z 6ix9ine Rock Nation theory video that I did like a week ago. You know what I mean? You see a lot of people uploading a lot of different videos, but remember, Carfee was on this stuff kind of first, honestly. You know what I mean? I'm not trying to toot my own horn or nothing like that. But the Snoop video, like, people are dropping similar videos right now. I did this like a week ago. The Rock Nation theory and all that, I did that like a week ago. You know what I mean? So the links for those will be in the comments, but check the timeline. I've been had this up. But, you know, Snoop stepped in, said something to 6ix9ine. And, you know, with the whole Meek thing, which might have been looking like a setup, like Meek and 6ix9ine might have been working together. But anyways, 6ix9ine was happy about that because he was able to dig up that dirt on Snoop and be dissing him and all that. And we'll talk a little more about that in a second. But the idea behind that, why 6ix9ine was so happy, is because he can try to pull other people down to his level or find common ground where people might want to socialize with him and rock with him. You know what I mean? And maybe people will just forget about this, or people will fully accept him. You know what I mean? Even though he's got the hit, he's got the money, I'm telling you, this guy's dying inside. Because even though the first time around, when he was running around doing all that trolling and everything, you know what I mean? We all knew 6ix9ine wasn't really built like that. We knew he wasn't tough like that. But he was able to act like that and talk that shit because there was no dirt on him necessarily. You know what I mean? I mean, there was, but there was never a straight up substantial, like, for sure, you know, ruling across the board, 6ix9ine is tarnished. You know what I mean? He weaseled his way up out of that case. A lot of people were giving him a pass, saying, nah, that's not really what happened, and etc. You know what I mean? He was getting a pass from a lot of people. But now there's a flat out ruling unanimously. 6ix9ine's a rat. He's a rat. Even though he can do all these things, he's still always going to not be able to shake that snitch jacket. It's funny I accidentally said snake there too, because he'd be doing some snakish type movements. But anyways, something No Jumper was pointing out, and basically what ties into with what I'm saying on here, right? 6ix9ine did the live, he got the views, you know, all that stuff, but no rappers were really fucking with him. You know what I mean? Period. And that's what I'm, you know, trying to get at here is we knew this dude would probably still be popular, but who's really gonna fuck with him from inside hip hop? Who really is gonna? You know what I mean? Something that they pointed out, you might have seen a little issue going back and forth. A dude named DDG, who honestly is like a huge YouTuber and an up-and-coming rapper. And I really did not know about this guy until recently. You know what I mean? He got mad at No Jumper because they were pointing out, saying, yo, no rappers are in 6ix9ine's comments shouting him out, except for the DDG guy, who, you know, they're saying, yo, man, you're more of a YouTuber. So he got mad about that. He got a little hot about that. But, you know, that's true. That's actual factual. No, like, solidified rappers are back in 6ix9ine or shouting 6ix9ine out. You know what I mean? So that's what all this is about. And it looks like he might have somewhat got a cosign or someone to show him a little attention within Akon, right? Akon's the first one really within the industry, even though he's not a rapper, you know, he's like R&B or a singer or whatever you want to call him. Akon definitely has solid roots within hip hop. Now, Akon did shout, like, kind of speak in 6ix9ine's favor before 6ix9ine ever got out. That might have been why 6ix9ine targeted him with this whole thing, calling, you know, trying to challenge him to this battle that he agreed to or whatever. And I don't know if the battle went down or not. I don't really care. I probably ain't going to tune into it. But with Akon doing that, 6ix9ine's really happy. You know what I mean? Because here's a real figure, you know what I'm saying? A real figure within the hip hop industry who's willing to kind of work with them in a sense. You know what I mean? So 6ix9ine hopes that he can keep doing all this trolling and all this work, all this campaign, you know what I mean, to get more people to work with them. And then, you know, this will all but be forgotten. You know, this, he's hoping that people will look at Snoop as a rat also. And then, you know, say, all right, we're cool. We're cool with 6ix9ine. Forget this. And he'll just become, things will go back to where the way they were. And he will be fully accepted. Now, you guys can tap in with your comments and let me know your thoughts on that. As always, I want to hear what you guys got to say. If you've been rocking with the channel, you already know that it's what it's all about over here. But if you're new, that's what the J Coffee Talk platform is all about. So get in the comments. Let me know your guys' thoughts and definitely sub to the channel and hit that bell. We also cover other news, sports, current events, a lot of different stuff on this channel. Now, another big part of 6ix9ine trying to do all this hard work, you know what I mean? Because I'm telling you, this is killing this guy inside. Even though you, like, a lot of people of his fans are saying, oh, he's laughing, he's happy, look how good he's doing. I'm telling you, he's still dying inside that he's got that tarnish on him. You know what I mean? Money ain't everything, and he wants what he had back. You know what I mean? He doesn't necessarily have it. I'm telling you, that stain on his jacket is killing this guy. You know what I mean? Now, the snitching stuff with Snoop Dogg was a big part of that. And we saw 6ix9ine post something recently saying something about, there's a lot of your favorite rappers that are snitches, okay? And that's true. I mean, let's talk about this. Some people have told before and it's kind of been forgot or whatever. Briscoe, you might remember him from Cash Money. He got robbed in a barber shop. They ran up in there with the strap. And he got on the stand and pointed people out. People were convicted. Who else? Lil C's. Word was he did a little telling in that Lil Kim case. And some people considered it to be snitching when he gave a description for the artist drawing of the shooter of Biggie Smalls, right? Now, that's what I'm saying. It's all up to you, how you feel about snitching. You know what I mean? A lot of people look at that as, like I said, not everyone's a street individual. A lot of people feel, yo, he was just like, his man got killed. You know what I mean? And that's what I'm saying. Not everyone's a hardened gangster. You feel me? But a lot of people felt that like that was snitching, what Lil C's did, given that drawing for, you know, the Biggie shooter. Now, T.I., Grand Hustle, he dismissed two people from the label, which is funny enough because T.I. kind of is considered to be a snitch to some people. The way he got up out of that Fed case still never makes sense to me. You know what I mean? But and then the testimony in the murder, you know, that he did of his homie Phil. Some people consider that snitching. I mean, at the end of the day, like I said, it's how much of a street individual are you? You know what I mean? But he also, there was a dude named Alpha Mega who was a part of Grand Hustle, and some paperwork came out on him that he was in federal informant, and he kicked him off Grand Hustle. Also, Young Dro, another, you know, really, really tight homie of on Grand Hustle that was T.I.'s man. They actually came up together from the same hood as and everything. And it came out a year or two ago that Young Dro had told on someone within their camp when they were on tour or something like that, another rapper over something small too, like a weed charge or something, I believe. You know what I mean? Capone of Capone and Noriega. Prodigy detailed it in his audiobook. You know what I'm saying? That Capone took the stand in the trial of Havoc of Mobb Deep's brother, Killer Black, and did some telling. You know what I mean? And Capone admitted to it. But the jury is still kind of out on that when it comes to the streets. Some people say Capone lied and bamboozled the police into giving him a deal to get a lighter prison sentence when he actually gave bad information that, you know, didn't match up and corroborate the facts of the case, and that ended up helping Killer Black come home. You know what I mean? Some people say he told, some people say he just was playing checkers with the police. You guys let me know what you think about all this. And then, what, like, I gotta once again point out my previous video that I did, the Jay-Z Roc Nation 6ix9ine theory video. It's come out recently that Jay-Z has someone who is a high-ranking associate who works for Roc Nation, who was a DEA informant and put a lot of people away, like a whole cartel. You know what I mean? So yes, telling has went on from time to time within hip hop, right? But you know what I mean? It's still not fully accepted, and 6ix9ine is at all this hard work trying to get everyone to forget about it or to just accept him again. That's what this whole campaign's about. Now, ending this video, the last thing I want to touch on is Snoop Dogg responding to this. Like I said, I got a video on this like a week ago as well. 6ix9ine or Snoop Dogg's responded to, you know, the claims that he told. Like I said, Reggie Wright put this out like a whole year ago or so. He said Suge Knight or when Snoop was beefing with Suge Knight, some Death Row affiliates put the hands on him at the amphitheater in California, and Snoop and Daz ran to the police. There is actual paperwork on this. Snoop Dogg says it's false. His fake paperwork, you see his response, he says, false, I've never got slapped, and I don't do no informing. Those are all statements from a police officer, not me. Try again, Rainbow Boy. So, you know, you guys get in the comments. Let me know what you think about this whole situation here with Snoop, what he's saying, if you feel like he's lying. I gotta say, Snoop lost a lot of points with people with the whole Gayle King thing, the way he came out at her when she was disrespectful, you know, to Kobe Bryant. Rest in peace once again to the great Kobe Bryant. Shortly after his passing, you know what I'm saying? She said some things that were, I don't know, I didn't like her interview technique, we'll say that. But the point was, is after that, you know what I'm saying, Snoop had some things to say to her, and then next thing you know, he's doing that Red Table Talk interview, and I don't know, man, that it almost seemed like Snoop was shook, like some of the elite people reached out to him and said, yo, Snoop, you better fall back. You can't be talking like that to Gayle. Like, what's wrong with you? And he did that Red Table Talk interview, and I don't know, man. It was like a therapy session or something for the public to see, like some stuff that should have been behind closed doors. Snoop was showing his soft side, getting emotional and everything for the whole world to see, which it was just kind of weird. You know what I'm saying? So Snoop already lost points to a lot of people when that went on. And now 6ix9ine, that might have been part of the reason. Well, actually, you know, strike that, because Snoop was the one that spoke out to 6ix9ine. So 6ix9ine didn't actually target him. But like I said, 6ix9ine was happy about that. You know what I mean? Because he knows these things. Yo, Snoop just lost a lot of points with the people with that whole Gayle King fiasco. Yo, there's paperwork on Snoop. You know what I mean? So it was a good person for him to try to push his cause, to bring other people down to his level, to make him be looked at the same again and accepted once again within the hip hop world. You know what I mean? But that's all I got on this one, guys. I want to hear your thoughts on this whole thing. Like I said, make sure to sub to the channel, hit the bell, but let's get this discussion going. I'll catch you guys on the next video. I'm out of here. Peace.